Welcome once again. In this session, we are going to discuss eye pattern. In the baseband PM signal, intersymbol interference and the channel noise is the major problem. And that can be minimized using raised cosine roll-off filter, which we have discussed in our last video lecture. Now, the distribution of an intersymbol interference can be easily observed by displaying the received waveform, that is discrete PAM signal, on an oscilloscope. On the basis of observation, there is a display of a pattern after superposition of every length TB, that is bit duration, across the channel output. And this pattern is like a human eye, hence called eye pattern. To explain in brief, consider input waveform, that is a type of discrete PM signal. For example, 10110110001. Having positive amplitude pulse for symbol 1 and negative amplitude pulse for symbol 0. While transmitting through the baseband channel, that is a type of low pass channel, there is introduction of inter-symbol interference and noise. So, we get a distorted signal that is shown in figure. Now, on an oscilloscope screen, there is a superposition of every bit duration TB or maybe twice of TB as per our convenience. And here we consider a superposition of every TB length duration across the distorted channel that is shown in figure. The superposition of every waveform with respect to bit duration TB make a pattern that is like a human eye and called as eye pattern. From this eye pattern, the performance of the baseband PAM system can be monitored and analyzed using many parameters that is typically shown in figure. At the best sampling time, we get appropriate eye pattern that is based on Nyquist criteria for distortionless transmission. Here the horizontal block represents the distortion at the sampling time. The first information that we have obtained from eye pattern is the width of eye opening. The width of the eye opening is the time interval over which the received wave can be sampled with intersymbol interference. And the best time for sampling is when the eye is open widest. During this process, there is a distortion of zero crossing, which varies as the width of eye opening may change. Next information is the sensitivity to timing error. The sensitivity of the PAM system to the timing error delta T is represented by the rate of closure of eye and can be obtained by varying the sampling rate. Here, the sensitivity of timing error is represented by the slope of the eye pattern that is shown in figure. Third observation is the height of eye opening. The height of eye opening at a specific sampling interval defines the margin over noise, or simply called noise margin. And the last observation is the effect of intersymbol interference. When intersymbol interference is very severe in baseband PM system, there is a complete closure of eye, which is undesirable condition. So, on the basis of above information, we summarize a point. First, we consider a noise-free channel. In this case, the eye opening has two values. First, when it is unity, then the effect of intersymbol interference becomes zero, while when the eye opening is zero, there is a severe effect of intersymbol interference. Typically, the eye opening of 0.5 or better value gives a reliable data transmission. Next, we consider a noisy channel. In this situation, we consider noise margin that is indicated by the height of eye opening. The extent of eye opening at optimum sampling rate provides a measure of operating margin over additive channel noise, that is margin over noise. And the extent of eye opening can be determined in terms of peak distortion for inter-symbol interference. And its formula is eye opening equals to 1 minus peak distortion. Here, peak distortion is dimensionless, so the eye opening is also dimensionless. The relationship between D peak, that is peak distortion, and eye opening is shown in figure. In this, the ideal signal level is scaled to lie inside range minus 1 to plus 1. And the width of eye opening represent the symbol period capital T. And the corresponding height represent noise margin, that is eye opening. In this relation, the peak distortion is measured in twice, that is for positive and negative level. Next, using relation eye opening equals to 1 minus peak distortion, when peak distortion is equals to 0, eye opening is unity. That is the case of zero inter-symbol interference. And when peak distortion is unity, the eye opening is completely closed. That is the case of severe inter-symbol interference. And in order to overcome this inter-symbol interference problem, we first consider a baseband transmission of digital data. Output Vi is equals to mu times of summation ak P I minus K plus Ni. That is a compact form. Now separate the summation for K equals to I and K not equals to I. When we consider K equals to I, we get first term, that is mu times of AI, which is the desirable output. But the second term represents the inter-symbol interference. Here, the inter-symbol interference is given by the summation, that is summation ak p I minus k for k not equals to I. When this inter-symbol interference is maximum, then it is called peak distortion, and it is given by summation mod p I minus k for value k not equals to I. At maximum inter-symbol interference, each encoded symbol AK has the same algebraic sign as PI minus K. This peak distortion introduces a maximum inter-symbol interference, but for all I equals to K, there is a normalization of overall pulse spectrum denoted by P naught equals to 1. So in baseband transmission of digital data, there is the introduction of inter-symbol interference, and this ISI can be observed and analysis using eye pattern. With the help of eye pattern, we can find peak distortion. And with the help of peak distortion, we can minimize the inter-symbol interference using a raised cosine rule of spectrum. Next, we are going to discuss baseband M array PAM transmission. As we have discussed in our last video lecture about baseband binary PAM system. In this system, the pulse amplitude modulator called line encoder, which produces a binary pulse having one of the two possible amplitude levels denoted by A suffix K. The value of AK is plus 1 for input BK equals to 1 and minus 1 for input binary BK equals to 0. This level encoded signal is based on non-return to 0 coding and represented by positive and negative pulses of fixed amplitude but having a very short duration, assuming unit impulse of opposite polarity, which correspond to binary symbol 1 or 0. While in case of baseband M array PM system, the line encoder produces one of the M possible distinct amplitude levels, especially M is greater than 2. In M array PM system, each M amplitude level represents distinct symbol, which is to be transmitted, called discrete PAM signal. That is denoted by S function T equals to summation AK into G T minus K TB, with limits K equals to minus infinity to plus infinity. Here, TB is bit duration and 1 upon TB is called signaling rate of the system and expressed in symbol per second or baud. 1 upon TB is also called baud rate. Here, we note a point. The impulse response GT of the transmit filter is same as rectangular pulse having unit amplitude with equal bit duration TB. At time t equals to 0, the impulse response G function 0 is equals to 1 volt. So in discrete PAM signal, the function GT is periodic rectangular pulse. So, in M array PAM system, the encoded signal AK having distinct level depend upon the even and odd value of capital M, called M array. When M is even, the input binary data BK is encoded to AK, having distinct level plus minus A, plus minus 3A, plus minus 5A, etc. While in case of odd M, AK is 0, plus minus 2A, plus minus 4A, etc. So, this is a level encoded signal AK corresponding to input binary data BK and based upon M array for even value and for odd value. To explain M array, we consider a quaternary system, that is M equals to 4. Having input binary sequence BK equals to 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Here, since the system is even, that is M equals to 4, the level encoded signal AK having plus minus A, plus minus 3A, etc. And for our convenience, we consider a die bit in input sequence BK. And accordingly, for each die bit, a distinct level is assigned. For example, 00 is assigned to level minus 3A, 01 to minus A, 10 to plus A, and 11 is assigned to plus 3A. And accordingly, our input binary sequence is level encoded by three distinct levels. That is, first die bit 01 is assigned by minus A. Second die bit 11 is assigned by plus 3A and third die bit 00 is assigned by level minus 3A. Here each level having a fixed duration capital T, that is called symbol duration. Here in M array, the symbol duration capital T is related to the bit duration TB. And the relation is T equals to TB log M to base 2. Here, log M to base 2 is called 1 baud and expressed in bits per second